But let's take stock of the situation on the ground. N. Srinivasan, the Vice Chairman and Managing Director of India Cements, is with us. Mr. Srinivasan, good morning and thanks so much for joining us. What kind of demand trends are you noticing for the cement space in general and particularly in southern India?
Actually, if you take demand as a whole, the last year on year, the demand growth was 6%. Mm. This year, if you take the country as a whole, I think it will be plus 10%.
Oh.
And the south is growing at about 14%, the east at about 18%, the west, north and central India, the growth is not much because I think they are fully sold out. See, I think there is a case to say that there is unsatisfied demand in those areas. And I think next year you will see demand-supply balancing throughout the country. And the year after that, with hardly any capacity coming on stream, because we are now 400 million tons, over the next 2 years, maybe 18 million tons may be added, which is nothing. And the fact that because of environment restrictions, it takes a long time to set up a plant, a greenfield plant, even a brownfield plant. So it takes what was 18 months is now almost 3 years. So I think we are heading into a 3-4 year period when demand may be better than supply.
Okay. That will be good, of course, for cement makers. Good morning, Mr. Srinivasan, and greetings for Dasera and Navratri. There is this funding crunch which usually affects real estate companies, contractors first. You don't see that spoiling the party even in the short run?
No, you see, if you ask me, where is this growth come from? I mean, 8 months ago, it was not there.
Mm.
It is a lot of infrastructure, housing, private sector housing, housing for weaker sections, governmental construction of roads, but at the moment money is flowing into these sectors.
Okay.
There is no funds crunch. For example, even the Kaleshwaram dam that is being built in Telangana, there is no funds crunch that is apparent.
Okay. When you talk about infrastructure, is the demand driven by government spending on infrastructure? Because that's something that we've been hearing for a while now. Or are we even seeing some demand uptake from private capex as well?
Both. A large part of it is government driven because roads are being built. Also, private sector, see, the non-trade demand for OPC cement is quite high. And also, private sector housing is picking up.
Mm-hmm.
You see, for example, Tamil Nadu had a problem with sand that has been that is not there today. Overall, there is a buoyancy. It is difficult to pinpoint one reason for it.
Okay, so will
Kerala... Okay, just in the same vein, is Kerala showing more demand after the disaster they had to face?
Kerala has recovered very well, actually. Kerala has recovered very well and demand is good there now.
Okay. Will better demand both in government infrastructure as well as private aid prices in the near term? I mean, have the prices gone up post the monsoon? And if yes, what has the range been?
My assessment is, you see, the people are only now coming to terms with the fact that demand supply is starting to match. So I expect from January March quarter, you will see an upward trend in prices also.
So are you saying for the second half, cement companies will show better volume as well as better margins?
Better margin in the last quarter, January March quarter, yes, definitely.
Okay, Mr. Srinivasan, just hold on. I just want to point out this housing finance sell-off is now getting bigger because, you know, the latest to join is Repco Home Finance, and there's a massive open interest buildup that you're seeing on Repco Home Finance. That stock now making lows of the day. Just see the intraday chart on Repco Home, down about 2%, and there's, I think, 13 or 14% open interest buildup that you're seeing on this stock right now. You spoke about DHFL, that's still down about almost 10%. Scanfin Homes, which is making lows, so, and the Repco stock has also joined in the party. So, bit of a short play on right now as far as some of these housing finance stocks are concerned, Lata?
You know, yesterday I was reading out chapter and verse from the Credit Suisse report, which was indicating that this looks like a long haul, especially for housing finance companies, but largely for all NBFCs, with debt funds not getting as much money and therefore not being able to roll over CPs, but more importantly, probably asset liability mismatches as well. So yes, now it's the mid-caps index is now down to only 0.2%. Remember, it started off with a 1.2% gain, and much of the shaving off of the gains in the mid-cap space has come from the NBFC, or rather housing finance space. Mr. Srinivasan, let's thank you on that note. Have a great festival season, sir. The markets have just taken a bit of a turtle.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us. Anuj, anything particular? You know, the Sensex and the Nifty actually seem to have found their feet after the initial correction.
No, I think the mid-caps, the way it's falling, I think 40 points in the green only now for the market. You know, the point we were making in the morning as well, Lata, that, you know, perhaps at these levels, the risk-reward is not in your favor. You're chasing things first thing in the morning, you know, you might get stuck. And today, for now, at least for intraday, the sell-on rally has worked. What will be interesting is if at any point the buying resumes. So I think the stock to watch would really be HDFC Bank, because that's the one which sort of controls the Nifty Bank. Yesterday you saw this FI selling returning in some of these names. So that I think is the decisive factor. But make no mistake about it, that the NBFC rally that we had, lock, stock and barrel, that is over. It's now only select two or three stocks. Otherwise, you know, obviously there's a bit of a problem.
And you know,
here,
the NBFC rally is not just for NBFC stocks. Okay. It was also fueling economic activity. And that cannot be replaced by the banks at this juncture, because banks lack capital and the private sector banks lack liquidity. The private sector bank loan to deposit ratio is running almost 100%. In some cases, it's running even more than 100%, which means they're borrowing short to lend. And therefore, nobody is quite able to step into the shoes left vacant by the NBFC companies. And that can hurt economic activity. At the moment, to be fair, Mr. Srinivasan is not speaking about it.
Yeah.
So real economy is not complaining about it just yet. But the market is smelling trouble.
Yeah, market's smelling trouble. In fact, let's, if we have Ashwini with us, just for a moment, just to see if, you know, if the, okay.
Mid-caps are in flat terrain now, the index.
Ashwini, is this a bit of a culmination of rally, or too early to speak, the way the market's seeing a bit of a slip from the highest point?
If we are just talking today, then there's a bit of a theme which is starting to build up, and sometimes that has a reason. So, you know, housing finance, financials overall are not able to show any sort of big, you know, follow-through. But you can have two bad days, get very close to 10,500, 550, and then again resume rally. Now, we'll have to see how bad does it get, because everybody is long for last 3 days. Now, all of those guys are now trapped. So is this FII selling? Is this just profit booking? So far, it looks like, you know, a bit of theme is building up over the NBFCs. But as long as 10,500, 550 holds on, there can be another attempt on the upside. But if in the afternoon, you know, something new comes out, then, you know, all bets are off, and obviously risk reward is clearly in favor of going short.
You know, also, Ashwini, is the way in which the NBFC logic has worked, it looks very difficult for them to rise on their feet again. One odd company, a Sundaram Finances, companies that never went into trouble will perhaps stay. But the sector is not going to be anywhere near what it was. And in fact, it will be a drag on the system. But can't the indices climb despite it?
See, the issue is that that has kind of become an indication of the market, of the economy. And if there is trouble anywhere in the financial sector, that has a big impact. And the problem also is portfolios, everybody is, you know, loaded up on NBFC. So if NBFC decline restarts and their paper is all over the place, everybody owns it, you know, that becomes a trouble, because it becomes a cascading kind of effect.
Yeah, in fact, that's visible now in Chola Mandalam Finance and Shriram Transport Finance. Both these stocks, intraday, if you just see the chart on both Chola Mandalam Finance and Shriram Transport Finance, again, same way, you're seeing a decline and a lot of open interest build up in a couple of these names. So Just keep tracking some of these.
You know, I also wanted to point out that the global markets should also be kept in context, because a lot of them have come off from the highs, and we have a holiday tomorrow. The Dow futures are indicating now, the initial signs are that there could be a fall in the US markets. So maybe people may not want to leave their positions open ahead of the holiday tomorrow.
Having said that, we are still in the green, and that too by a large margin. You know, the market is still up 270 points on the Sensex, 73 points on the Nifty. And if you, you know, bought yesterday, you're still making a lot of money. The only point is, if you chase today, today's open, perhaps, you know.
Yeah, those who bought today in the morning will not be in the money at this point in time. But not a whole lot. I mean, Sensex and Nifty are still kind of, you know, 0.7% in the green. We'll track it, of course, minute by minute, tick by tick. But let's also remind you of the big event on CNBC TV18's radar. Uday Kotak, the founder and promoter of Kotak Mahindra Bank, was most recently appointed by the government to the board of the debt-strapped INFS as well. He is also last year's winner of CNBC TV18's India Business Leader Award. Watch him in action as he chairs an excellent jury at the India Business Leader Awards jury round, the most coveted business awards in India. IBLA, as it returns the 14th year now. That action begins at 2 this afternoon, and you will be able to watch it clip by clip on CNBC TV18.